For a year and a half.
I think for my patients, at 75%.
That's excellent.
Do you resort to second rock operation?
No.
After?
No.
I totally agree with you.
Yeah, thanks. Okay, the Professor Ashraf Nasr from Zagazi. Thank you. When you give new adjuvant chemotherapy and then you do your surgery after 3 to 4 cycles of chemotherapy, that's the correct term is delayed primary debulking, because this is your first debulking. And you delayed that first debulking until the patient gets 3 or 4 cycles. So that's delayed primary debulking. Interval debulking means that you've gone to do surgery and you've left a little bit of tumor and give the patient some chemotherapy, and you came back after an interval to do the second operation to remove the rest of the tumor. And that should not be the practice, you know. Exactly. You know, our honorable colleague, Professor Frank Lawton, in 1983 did a study with David Loosley from the UK, and they discounted that practice. And it's actually one of the very good studies that showed that interval debulking does not improve survival. The Americans use it, with all due respect to my colleagues from America here. Yes, Prof. We occasionally do that. Yes, that's, I entirely agree with you, but that's not the standard. Another example of that is patients with low-grade serous carcinomas. The ones with low-grade, you know that they can live with disease for 10 years, okay? But that disease inside their abdomen might cause them symptoms. It's not going to shrink. It gets fibrosed and calcified and does not disappear. You do CT scans and still there. And despite that, she's not showing good response radiologically on the chemotherapy. Maybe we need to do a PET scan to assess her rather than the ordinary CT scan. But on occasions, those with low-grade serous carcinomas, you might need to go in and take their disease out. Okay, thank you very much.